Welcome. This is the first of a series of three videos on polynomial division. This video focuses on dividing by a monomial. To divide a polynomial by a monomial, we divide each term by the monomial. If we let A, B, and C represent real numbers, variables, or algebraic expressions, such that C doesn't equal zero, the quantity of A plus or minus B divided by C is equal to A divided by C plus or minus B divided by C. Now this becomes pretty clear when we take a look at a specific example with values for A, B, and C. So for example, if we have 1 plus 2 over 3, we know we can add 1 plus 2 to get 3, and of course 3 over 3 is equal to 1. Well, what this is also telling us is we could rewrite this as 1 over 3 plus 2 over 3, as we see here, which we know we can add because we have a common denominator to get 3/3, which is also equal to 1. So this verifies that if we are dividing by a monomial, we can break it up into several individual fractions. So let's go ahead and give it a try. Over here on the right, I have provided the quotient rule for exponents. So we're dividing by the monomial 4x, which means we can rewrite this as 40x to the fourth over the monomial 4x minus 24x squared over 4x. Well, this simplifies nicely. 40 divided by 4 would give us 10. X to the fourth divided by x to the first, remember we subtract our exponents, that would give us x to the third. 24 divided by 4 equals 6. And x to the second divided by x to the first would equal x to the first, or just x. Now we can write a division problem involving a monomial in a variety of ways. As you can see here, number one is written as a fraction, but we can also write it as a division problem. So this would be the same as 32y to the sixth divided by 4y squared minus 8y to the third divided by 4y squared. And lastly, plus 2y squared divided by 4y squared. So now we just simplify each fraction individually to obtain our quotient. 36 divided by 4, that would give us 9. Y to the 6th divided by y to the 2nd, y to the 4th, minus 8 divided by 4, 2. Y to the 3rd divided by y to the 2nd, 3 minus 2 would give us y to the 1st, plus. Now here we have a fraction. 2/4 is equal to 1/2. And y squared over y squared, that would equal 1. So here's our quotient. Pretty straightforward. Let's go and take a look at one more that maybe looks a little more involved because we do have a polynomial with two different variables. But again, the process will be the same. We can see we have three terms in this polynomial. Therefore, when we rewrite this, we'll have three separate fractions. Each fraction will have a denominator of negative 3xy squared. So now we need to simplify each fraction individually. So the first step, we'll look at the coefficients. 12 divided by negative 3 equals negative 4. X to the third divided by x to the first, that would be x squared. Y to the seventh divided by y to the second, y to the fifth. 9 divided by negative 3 would be negative 3, but it's minus, so minus negative 3 would be a positive 3. X to the second divided by x to the first, that would give us x. Y cubed divided by y squared equals y to the first, plus 3 divided by negative 3, that's negative 1. X divided by x equals 1. And y squared divided by y squared equals 1. Now this looks a little funny here. Remember, adding a negative 1 is the same as subtracting a positive 1. So let's go ahead and rewrite this one more time as minus 1. So remember, this only applies when you're dividing by a monomial. The next two videos will take a look at how you divide by a binomial, and we'll take a look at long division and also synthetic division. Thank you for watching, and I hope you found it helpful.